Hi, do you ever feel the need to pay faster in krita? Like going from this to this in less than 2 hours? If yes, then let's talk about some krita shortcuts. First are some that you can use on the canvas. To move things around, you can hold space and drag your pen wherever you want on the tablet. To zoom in or zoom out, you can hold Ctrl space and drag your pen up or down, up for zooming in and down for zooming out. Or alternatively, you can hold Ctrl or space. It's also for zoom but less smooth, so I don't really know why it exists, but it's just another option that you can choose from, I guess. To rotate things around, you can hold shift space and drag your pen in a circular motion. Plus, you can tap 5 to return to the original state of 0 degree. Next are some shortcuts on brush and drawing tools. First, we got some basic ones like B for brush, F for fill, and E for eraser. While on the brush tool, we can hold V to draw a line. And while holding V, you can also hold shift to draw a perfectly horizontal or vertical line. We can change brush size by holding shift and drag your pen left or right. Left to make it small and right to make it big. To sample color, you can hold Ctrl and tap your pen on the color you want. Holding Ctrl and Alt will allow you to pick the original color on the current active layer. So what does this mean? For example, we choose a color and paint something on the canvas like this. Then usually we might reduce the opacity or apply some blending mode. If we just use Ctrl, it will pick the color we are seeing on the screen right now. And if we use that to paint on the same layer, the color will be different. But if we use Ctrl and Alt, it will pick the original color we chose in the beginning, ignoring all the blending mode and the opacity setting. Then we can continue to paint on the same layer without any color differences. Next, you can use the slash key to switch between the current and the previous brush while keeping the same settings. This is something very helpful when sketching. What I usually do is setting one brush at the eraser and use another one to draw and sketch and just squish back and forth between them. A super convenient shortcut. We are interrupting this video to happily announce that all this information will be available in a PDF format for free on my Ko-fi page. You can pay a visit by using the QR code on screen right now or using the link in the description box below. Thanks for your patience. For the next part, we have some shortcuts for layers and stuff. Here are some basic ones first. You can group layer by using Ctrl Z. Add new paint layer by using the insert key. You can merge with Ctrl E. You can use this on an active layer to merge it with the layer below, or on a group to merge with the whole group into one single layer. You can find a layer by holding R and tapping your pen where you want. This is of course something very useful when you have lots of layers, or when you are doing something like designing stuff where each of your elements is on a different layer. So you can just hold R, tap, and then move them wherever you want. This part is some shortcuts on selection slash lasso tools. As always, here's some basic ones first. We have Ctrl R to select things in a rectangle, J to do the same but in an ellipse shape. The freehand one is something we definitely use a lot more, but this one doesn't have a shortcut by default. So I really recommend you to customize one for yourself. And mine is on Q. You can hold shift while selecting to add to the selected area and hold alt to subtract from that selected area. To deselect everything, you can use Ctrl shift A. You can use Ctrl T to transform a selected area or the whole active layer if nothing is selected. and you can hold shift while transforming to keep the proportions the same. And finally, last but not least, here is an honorable mention to Kanchenji and Kanchenshifji for their relentless effort of undoing and redoing all our mistakes away. The true heroes of our art journey. And I think that's the video. Well, this is something that mostly is based on my own painting process. So if there is something that you feel like very useful but is not on this video, please share in the comment section down below so that we can all learn some new stuff together. And hopefully some of you may find something helpful from this list. Hope you have a great day or night, and see you later.